That's not the only new power we're going to introduce. Suppose that you wanted to square all of the numbers in the list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here's one way to do it. The function map takes a function as its first argument and then a list, and it applies that function to each element of the list in turn, creating a new list. So I'm going to make a new list down here that's the output of map, and we're going to take 1 and square it. So we get 1 times 1 is 1. Now we're going to take 2 and square it. 2 times 2 is 4. 3 and square it is 9. 4 and square it is 16. 5 and square it is 25. Each one of these led directly to part of my output. This function map is a big part of functional programming, and it's also a big part of how Google is able to make very scalable search engines and related services. MapReduce is an easily parallelizable functional programming paradigm. Lots of power here. I said that map takes a function as its first argument. One way to make a function is to define it earlier and refer to it by name, but we can also make a function right now, right in this expression when we need it, and pass that in. This map is going to produce the same result as the previous one. 1 times 1 is 1, 2 times 2 is 4, 3 times 3 is 9, 16, 25. But I didn't need to have my square defined in advance. This use of lambda is sometimes called an anonymous function because it was an important function, but we never actually gave it a name. But now here comes the real convenience. I'm going to show you a third way to make that list that's even more natural than the previous two. This approach is called a list comprehension. You ask for a list, but instead of actually putting elements in it, you write out a little formula here and then say that you want that formula applied for every element in some other list or collection. So this is saying for every x in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so x is going to be 1, and then it'll be 2, then it'll be 3, then it'll be 4, then it'll be 5. For each one of those, put x times x in the output list. These formulas can be arbitrarily complicated, any expression you like. So here, x is going to be hello, and then my, and then friends. And we're going to make a list out of the length of each of those. So that's going to be 5, and then 2, and then, actually, you tell me. What's going to show up here?